Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today's video is just going to be another eye tutorial. I used some of the Wet n Wild pigments that I haul, and I'm also using the new Wet n Wild cushion foundation. So if you want to see how I got this, just keep on watching. Here I've already gone ahead and primed my eye just using some concealer. I am going in with the Jaclyn Hill palette, and I haven't been setting my concealer in a while, and I kind of like it. Anyways, I think I was listening to music here. Moving on, I'm just going to go ahead and show you the shades that I'm going to be using. I'm going to use quite a few shades from this palette to really deepen out that look, so I will let you just watch. So here I'm taking the NYX pigment primer again and the Wet n Wild pigment. I just wanted to show you the lid real quick because it's super helpful. And here I'm just applying the primer, and then I went right in with this pigment. I'll list the name down below. It's a really pretty gold, and I just wanted to use it in a video because I don't have any pigments from Wet n Wild, and these are really nice and the packaging is great. Okay, so here I'm just gonna go in with these three small brushes. I'm gonna take a combination of these brushes, and it's basically gonna be to add a little bit more color into those transition shades that are a little bit lost, and it helps give a little bit more definition. So I just wanted to share the three detail brushes that I like the most. Okay guys, so for the face, I decided to try this. This is the new Wet n Wild Mega Cushion Foundation. It has SPF 15. It just says liquid foundation in a cushion compact, luminous, lightweight, and buildable hydrating formula. So I just saw this at Walgreens and decided to pick it up because I like trying new foundations. Anyways, this was a drugstore one. I did pick up the color 128 natural beige. It says medium neutral, so I hope it matches me. This is what the packaging looks like. It's super cute. So it comes with this little sponge. Honestly, I'm not gonna use it because I don't want to. I hope it matches me. I really think it will. I'm gonna go ahead and use the Maybelline sponge for this. I'm just gonna dip into the product. It doesn't really pick up a lot, so I pressed it in a little bit more there. It smells good. I don't know, it has a good scent, but great, the sun is going down right when I need it. Anyways, you can see what that's looking like compared to this side here, so I think it looks really nice so far. It does feel hydrating, and it feels wet, I guess. Well, any foundation does, but very hydrating. Let me zoom you in a little bit so you can see. It's definitely on the glowy side. I'm liking this foundation so far. It looks really nice. It has good coverage. It doesn't smell weird. It's affordable. The sponge didn't soak up too much product, I would say. I would say it had good coverage. See, now the sun is coming. Anyways, for blush, I'm going to go in with this NYX blush. This is in the color Terracotta. I actually found this at my grocery outlet. They just put up a new grocery outlet right behind my house. And these were $2. They have a little bit of makeup, so of course I looked through it and this just looked nice. And of course for highlight, I'm going to go in with the Wet n Wild Highlighting Gold Bar in the color Holly Gold. Holly Gold Head. Anyways, this was part of the set that I hauled in my haul video along with these pigments. So I'm just going to go ahead and apply this. So for lips, I think I'm just going to go in with this Wet n Wild Give Me Mocha. Okay guys, that completes today's look. I hope you enjoyed this eye look using these Wet n Wild pigments along with the Wet n Wild Cushion Foundation. I will just keep you guys posted on how it wears throughout the day. Let you know on my next video how that held up. So I will see you in my next one.